Welcome to GG's, and this is Queen of South Season 2. Starting where we left off, Teresa with vengeance and Kamala's business in ruins. They partner up and decide to move back to Texas to avoid the chaos and regroup. They make it to Texas, just barely escaping from the DEA. They now need to figure out how to rebuild their business, from finding new suppliers to mapping out new routes. Teresa proposes to use the diary and points out they can approach King George for new shipping routes from Mexico. Teresa and James set up a meeting with King George. Initially unimpressed, he gets wooed by Teresa's wits and decides to partner up. With shipping routes done, the next step is to finalize supply, and they contact Don Emmanuel for the same. Aware of the turmoil between Camilla and Epifanio, Don Emmanuel is ready to supply, but only against advance payment. Being short on cash, they decide to rob cartel horse race, but Teresa comes up with a better plan. Instead of robbing, they decide to manipulate the race and bet on the horse with maximum winning odds. And with some doing, they are able to do so and are now ready for business. Teresa is also looking out for Tony, Brenda's son, and sets him up at a safe house. On the other hand, DEA agents are pressing Guerrero for more information. Getting to know that Teresa is in Texas, Guerrero gives up the location of Camilla's warehouse and they move to Texas. Being partners, Camilla introduces Teresa to her lawyer and his wife, Kellen. It is his firm that has helped Camilla create the shipping company which they will be using for cargo. It is here when Teresa meets Guerrero and is shocked to see him alive. Not having much time to catch up, Guerrero lets Teresa know that he has been working with the DEA and wants to meet her later. When Teresa catches up with Guerrero, he explains what made him run, leaving her behind. But before Teresa can comprehend, the DEA shows up. They want Teresa to be an informant and threaten her with deportation and give Teresa some time to think it over. Camilla has been suspecting an informant as her warehouse was raided, and the same is confirmed by their mole in Sheriff's Department, Danny. Since they don't know the identity of the informant, they decide on torturing the DEA agent prior to picking up the Mexican shipment. But Teresa, knowing the informant to be Guerrero, foils the plan. Left with no choice, they need to go to pick the Mexican shipment. But the DEA has set a trap, as they have caught one of Don Emmanuel's men and are waiting for the exchange. Meanwhile, in Mexico, with Epifanio losing his lieutenants, Colonel Cortez, who led the assault, wants to fill in the void. His aggressive approach pisses Epifanio, and he asks Batman to take care of him. But Colonel has an upper hand, and he kills Batman, leaving Epifanio no choice but to be in a forced alliance with him. Colonel wants to strengthen the cartel, and thus arranges for a sit-down between Epifanio and Don Emmanuel. Epifanio lets Don Emmanuel know that moving forward, he will have to work for him. But he is not convinced, and before he could do anything, his brother takes him out and agrees to the term set by Epifanio. Epifanio learned that Colonel already knew about Boa's intentions. Epifanio warns Colonel not to keep him in the dark again. Colonel lets Epifanio know that he wants to go after Camilla, as she has destroyed the tunnels they used for transportation. Back in Texas, James and Teresa become sitting ducks as the DEA raids the exchange. Guerrero, in an attempt to help them, ends up killing the DEA agent, and they are able to escape. Camilla, knowing Guerrero to be the rat, wants to put him down. Guerrero, knowing the recent shift in power in Mexico, offers Camilla an introduction with a new supplier, El Santo from Bolivia, in exchange for his life. El Santo has a cult following and doesn't do business with everyone. But Teresa is able to prove her worth. She is able to pass every test of El Santo, and El Santo is willing to work with her and won't deal anything below a metric ton. James is a bit apprehensive, but Teresa agrees, and El Santo gives them a week to complete the payment. With such large quantity, they need a bigger distributor and thus approach one of the biggest Southwest distributor and ex-Korean mob boss. He is impressed with the quality of the product and agrees to buy. Knowing one of their biggest distributor might deflect, Epifanio takes him out, sending a message to everyone else. Epifanio also uses his power as the governor and sets up a joint task force with the DEA, and Colonel stays back to help out. Camilla, losing her distributor, eyes Devin, another major player in the business and has no ties to Epifanio. She asks Cole to set up a meet. Devin is, however, not interested. So now they have to force him to the table, and they do so by pushing superior quality products on his turf in Chicago, and they are able to grab his attention and he is ready for a sit down. As they are about to leave, Colonel Cortez is able to locate them in Chicago and catches hold of James. He tortures him for information when the DEA shows up, and in the mix-up, they are able to escape. Guerrero and Teresa were planning to leave, but seeing the recent attack on James, Pota lets Guerrero know that Teresa will never be safe till Epifanio is after her. So Guerrero decides to leave and fix his mistake. The DEA are trying to track the ownership details of the shipping company where drugs were busted, but so far have had no luck since all the filing has been done offshore. So they go after Kellen, Cole's wife, and tell her the true nature of her husband's business with Camilla. She's surprised, shocked, and afraid. On the other hand, Colonel Cortez wants to go after Camilla and thinks it will be easier to ask for forgiveness than permission. He uses Camilla's daughter Isabella to trick Camilla to come to a nightclub. With no security by her side, it is Teresa once again to the rescue. She calls in the DEA. The DEA shows up and arrests Camilla just in time. Camilla, being in jail, wants them to maintain the status quo and continue with the business. Teresa continues to break out of a shell as she arranges for Camilla's security inside the prison. Kellen already knew about Camilla's affair with her husband, and now, knowing the true nature of their business, is fanatically looking for documents in her husband's office. Worried, she calls Teresa and asks her to come immediately. As Teresa shows up, they have found two files. One with Camilla being the owner of the shipping company, and the other with Teresa as the owner of the company. It is when Coles shows up. Seeing his safe being opened, he threatens his wife, and Teresa confronts him. Teresa wants him to explain the existence of two files. He lets her know one is for his safety and the second one is for Camilla's safety. And before Teresa could react, Kellen, being so upset, blows his head off. Learning about the fact, Teresa felt betrayed and decides to move out. Pota helps them in getting away and brings along Tony. But James has been tracking them and is able to find their location. And Camilla sends Danny to take them out and get the file back. DEA has also been tracking Kellen, and they were able to make it before Danny. As they try to negotiate with Teresa in giving up Camilla, Danny shows up and there is an intense shootout. Teresa survives, and knowing the fact that Camilla went after her, she leaves the ownership file of the shipping company with the DEA. This is the breakout moment for Teresa, as she decides to go for the throne, with Pota by her side, who lets her know everyone has a right to the throne, provided they could take it. Teresa arranges for a meeting between King George and Devin, and lets them know she will be moving out with Camilla and wants them to work with her. She already has an established connection with El Santo, and with King George as a transporter and Devin as the distributor, they can do much better. Teresa assures them of doing business a better way, and they agree for now. Devin asks Teresa to complete her first shipment, but Teresa doesn't have the drugs. She needs to steal it from Camilla with James being on guard. She recruits a new crew and goes after the drugs and manages to get them. But James has outsmarted her and switched the original product, and the deal is a bust. With a week being over, El Santo sent his men for collection of payment, and they give Teresa till sundown to make it. Meanwhile in Mexico, after surviving a heart attack, Epifanio wants to move out. So he decides to sell the business to Boaz. With the deal being final, Epifanio tries to take out Colonel for his betrayal and for killing Batman. But Colonel survived. He goes after Epifanio through his daughter Isabella. He manipulates Don Emmanuel's son into kidnapping Isabella and demand a ransom of $10 million. Epifanio breaks out Camilla and lets her know that their daughter has been taken. Camilla is able to decode a hidden message in her daughter's video. They decide to lure them out with the ransom and get Isabella out with a direct assault. Their plan is successful and James saves Isabella. The Vargas family is united and Epifanio wants them to be together and lets Camilla know that he is moving out of the business and he wants her to be with them and leave the business as well. While Camilla thinks, James approaches her and lets her know that they have completed the delivery to Devin and received the payment. James also wants to move out and wants 1/3 of the proceeds and Camilla agrees. As the plane lands, we find Guerrero is the one who has been flying and it is Teresa who called him for help. Teresa tries to negotiate with Camilla for giving up Texas, but Camilla is still not willing to give up. So in order to force Camilla out of business, Epifanio sacrifices himself so that Camilla could take care of their daughter. Devastated, Camilla tells Teresa to take the $10 million on plane and leave. Whereas Guerrero goes after James but lets him go. Teresa pays off El Santo and asks Guerrero to meet at the boat, but he never shows up. Colonel returns to Camilla and offers his loyalty. Season 2 ends with Teresa being independent and Camilla announcing to avenge her husband's death.